Hello my dear students, welcome again to my class. So today we will start a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Practical Geometry. Chapter number is 12. So in the, this chapter is about the constructions, about the construction of triangles also there and parallel lines also. There will be one line given, one point will be given like this. The question will be like this. For example, one line is given, question point will be there somewhere there. Question will be like this, that you draw a parallel line through this point. So directly with scale you cannot draw. You are to use your compass and by using the compass you are to draw this one. Okay, so we'll do one by one. You open exercise number 12A. Exercise 12A, question number 1. So you see very attentively. Later on I'll give you the steps of construction. So first of all you see how to construct. So question is given like this: draw a line segment AB. So first of all you have to draw a line segment AB. So I'll draw a line segment. This is my scale. You put your scale like this and measurement is given as 6.8. Up to 6.8. So this is the line AB, 6.8. So question is given like this. Okay, let me draw it. You just take it as 6 point. I will draw it. You take the correct measurement. I will take it little big or else you will not able to understand. So let it as line AB and thus it is given 6.8 centimeter. So this is line AB. It is given x centimeter, the 6.8 centimeter. So take any point P outside it. The question is to take any point P. So somewhere there, let me take a point P. So take any point P outside it. So simply I give a point and P I wrote. So take any point P outside it. Okay. So now the question is, using ruler and compass, draw a line through P parallel to AB. So you are to draw a line parallel to this one. So directly by using your scale you cannot do. You are to use your compass. So how to do a parallel line? So first of all, on this line AB I will take a point, any random point, any random point. So anywhere here, here, anywhere you like you can take. I am taking it here. So let me give it as point D. I simply gave here a point and I name it as point D. Okay, so now you see now you are to join these two points D and P. So I'll join these two. I join P and D. So now the now you take your compass and by taking any radius, it is not definite, so you can take any radius, but it should not be too much bigger or else you cannot it will be tough for you to do the arc. So you simple a small radius you take. Okay, so put the needle of the compass here and just simply give a arc like this. Okay, so I gave here a arc with same measurement. Don't do anything with your compass. With same arc you put it here and give a arc like this with same measurement. With this measurement, same measurement, you have to give another arc by putting your needle of the compass in the point P. At the point P you put the needle of the compass, the arc should be same. These two arcs should be same. So now now by this is the another point. So you got two point, you name it as this is D, this one you name it as E, this one F. This point is F, this one is E, this one is F, and you write it as H, E, F, G, एज ओके सो सॉरी यू वन थिंग यू डू यू गिव दिस आर्क ए नेम ओके सो यू राइट इट एज जी एच एंड दिस पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन यू राइट इट एज आई अगेन आई एम सेइंग फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई ड्रॉ ए लाइन देन एनी क्वेश्चन इज टू गिव ए पॉइंट पी आउटसाइड द लाइन ए बी सो आई गेव इट हियर ए पॉइंट पी नाउ देन टू ड्रॉ एनी पॉइंट आई हैव टेकन ए रैंडम पॉइंट on the line AB, any random point. So I took it here. You may take here, anywhere you want, you can take it, but it should be on the line AB. So I took it here with a arc, putting the needle of the compass at this point, this I draw a arc. Then again, putting the needle of the compass at that point, same arc, same, the radius should be same. The arc that I put here, the same radius I should give another arc and that point. So I gave this name. This point is E, this one is F, this point of intersection is I, and this the arc is GH. So now I will measure this arc from E to F. So you put the needle of the compass at this point E, and you simply measure the distance. So it is okay, this much. So with same measurements, I put the needle of the compass at E, and I just took the measurement of this point. The measurement of this arc. So I got this angle. So don't do anything with this. Simply with the same measurement, you put the needle of the compass at I at this point and give a small arc at that point. Now you simply join these two points, you will get the required parallel line. Simply join these two points, you will get the required parallel line. So you can name it as line L. The question was to draw a line and to give a point P outside it, and then you have to draw the parallel line through that point using your compass. So first of all, what I did, I took any random point on the line AB, I took it as D, there I took the point, then from this one and this one, I joined these two points, P and D. After joining, what I did, I simply took a radius, any random radius with this, any measurement, but it should not be too much big. So with a small radius, I simply draw an arc by putting the needle of the compass at D. And with same radius, I draw another arc by putting the needle of the compass at P. Then what I did, I put the needle of the compass at E and I measured this angle from here to here. I measured the distance by measured the radius. Then again, by putting the needle of the compass at I draw another arc which cuts at this point. So I'll name this point as J. This it is the name of the arc, it is G. This point is J. This one is D, E, F, I. This arc is H, G. GH is the arc. J is this point of intersection. I is this point of intersection. So now we'll write the steps of construction. So I am rubbing this one. After drawing this one, you write the steps of construction. How you have constructed this one, you have to write. Right, steps of construction. So first one will be what you have done. We have drawn a line segment. So you write, draw a line segment AB. What was his measure? Okay. Draw a line segment AB of length, it was 6.8, of length 6.8 centimeter, of length 6.8 centimeter, and take a point P outside
it.
And take a point P outside. Okay, in place of it, you write AB. Take a point P outside AB. Take a point P outside AB. So this is our first step. Second step, what we did? We took a random point. So take a point D on AB. So next point will be take a point D on AB. Take a point D on AB, and then we joined it with P, and join D to P. Join D to P, but P to D. What we did after taking the line, we took a random point, and then what we do? We simply joined these two. So I wrote this line here. So now Roman number 4. Step number 4 will be 3. So then what we did, we took the D as the center and a convenient radius we took, which okay, right, with D as center and a convenient so you write and convenient radius. So with D as center and a convenient radius, what we did? We draw an arc which cuts AB at the point E and PD at F. So you see the diagram, what I did, you see in your figure. So I would by taking D as center and a convenient radius, draw an arc cutting AB at point E and PD at F. So after drawing the arc, what we did? We took a radius from here, a convenient radius, and we cut like this, and we named this point as AB at E and this one at F. So now the next line I will write again. I will take with this same radius, I will cut this one, I will write. So step number 4 will be with P as center, and same radius as in step 3, and same radius as in step 3, draw an arc. What was the name of that arc? Draw an arc GH. Cutting PD at I. So what we did after taking this arc with the same measurement we took by putting the needle of the compass at this point P, we draw another arc GH which cut this line PD at I. So I wrote this line here with P as center and same radius as in step number 3. Draw an arc GH cutting PD at I. So it is step number 4. So now step number 5, with the same arc, what we did later on, then we measured this radius from E and F, and with same arc we cut here. So same line we will write, with the same arc EF, with the same arc EF, draw an equal arc. Draw an equal arc cutting GH at point J. Cutting GH at J. So with the same arc EF, draw an equal arc cutting GH arc at J. So I wrote this line. So now the last line of this construction, it will be join JP. What we did after that, we joined this line, joined J to P. Okay, you write JP at JP to draw a line L, and I named it as L. So join JP to draw a line L. So therefore you can write, then the line L, then the line L is the required line, is the required line parallel to AB, is the required line parallel to AB. Okay, so what we have seen, that we made this angle, this one and this one, same, then we can say that both the lines are parallel. So from where we have understood this one, in your earlier chapter geometry, in parallel lines, one chapter was there, parallel lines, there you have learned that if a transversal pass like this, then this angle, this one and this one are equal, alternate angles are equal. If this one is 60 degree, then this one also will be 60 degree. These two angles are always equal, and if these two angles are equal, then only we can say that the triangle, both the lines are parallel to one another. So same thing happened here. You measure this one, this angle, after drawing, and you measure this angle, you will find both these angles are equal, both of these angles are equal, which makes the both the line parallel to one another. So now question number 2, draw any triangle ABC, draw a line parallel to BC. So first of all, you have to draw a triangle ABC with any measurement, and then you have to draw a line parallel to BC. So same like this one, but little different. So with any measurement, you draw a triangle. Okay, I am drawing it. Any measurement you draw, and name it as ABC. Question is to draw a line parallel to this point. The line should pass like this, and both the lines should be parallel to one another. So you have to draw a line, parallel line at the point A. The question is, draw a line parallel to BC. So you have to draw a line parallel to BC at this point A. So how can you draw this one? Same like earlier one. Okay. So first of all, I will take, by putting at this the needle of the compass at point C, I will take a arc of a convenient radius. It should not be too much. It's okay. I took an arc. So same, with same measurement, you put the needle of the compass at dead point, and you draw another arc. So let me name this. It is let me name it as P, this one as Q, P and Q. Okay, and let me name this one as R. So the point data you'll get here, I will name it as S. So now you see, first of all, what I did, I draw a triangle with any measurement, then I put the needle of the compass at point C, and by putting the needle of the compass at this point, I simply draw an arc, and with same measurement I put the needle of the compass at point A and I draw another arc. So now you put the needle of the compass at point P, at this point, and you measure this length P and Q, you measure this arc, put the needle of the compass at point P. If I measure, it will be of this much length, yes. So with same measurement, you put at the point R and you draw a arc. So what I did, I simply took this measurement of this arc from P to Q, and with same angle I put the needle of the compass here and I draw another arc. So if I simply join these two points, it will be the line will be parallel to this line. You can it is R, then you can give this one as S. And you name it as X. Okay. So this will be your construction. What I did, you first of all you draw a triangle of any measurement. Then you take this point C and you put the needle of the compass, at that point, and you measure. Simply you draw a arc of any radius. With the same radius, you put the needle of the compass at point A and draw a same arc. Then by putting the needle of the compass at point P, you measure this arc P and Q, you measure the angle of this arc P and Q will be this much. So now you put this point at needle at R and draw a arc like this. You will get an intersection point, and through this point, point A and point S, you can draw a straight line which will be parallel to this one. So now you write the point steps of construction. So I'll write this one. Question number 2. First of all, you draw and then you write steps of construction. Steps of construction, Roman number 1. First one will be, what we did, we draw a triangle. So draw a triangle ABC of any measure. So now point number 2. Take C as center and a small radius. You write up to this much. Take C as center and a small radius. Radius should not be too much larger, or else you cannot draw it properly. So take C as center and a small radius. Draw an arc which cuts the BC line. The triangle was like this. So I have drawn an arc which cut the BC line at point. I named it as P and that one as Q. Okay, no need to write line. Which cuts BC at P. Write directly BC and this one is CA. Write directly BC and CA at P and Q. BC at P and this one at Q. So at P and Q respectively. Take C as center and a small radius which cuts the BC and CA at P and Q respectively.
Now what we did, we simply measured this one and so with same radius we draw another arc at that point and we named it as R. Now I'll write this line. With same radius, and center A, draw an arc which cuts AC at R, So I wrote this line with the same radius. I draw by putting the needle of the compass at A. I draw another arc which cuts AC at R. Now, step number 4. So now what we did? Now we will measure this PQ. So you write, measuring the arc PQ, using compass. By using compass, you have to measure this using. Okay, you can write or. Measuring the arc PQ using compass and cut the same arc length RA somewhere there. Measuring the arc PQ using compass and cut the same arc of length RS, you write. Okay, you can write like this. Of same arc length will be equals to RS. Okay. So now, step number 5, it will be, now what to do? We have to join AS. Join AS and extend up to X will extend. So join AS and extend to X. So right, then AX will be the required parallel line. Then AX is the required parallel line. Now question number 3. You see the question, it is given that draw a line segment of length 6.3 centimeter, draw another length and another line parallel it to it at a distance of 3 centimeter from it. So there are many ways of doing this one. Question is like this, that you are to draw a line and then you are to draw this parallel line which will be just 3 centimeter from this line. That means if they are 3 centimeter and they are also, it will be 3 centimeter everywhere, it will be 3 centimeter. So question is like this, one line is given and it is said to draw another line just 3 centimeter above it. So there are many ways of doing this one. You can by drawing to perpendicular line also we can do, or by drawing a simple one line and then by taking the measurement like earlier we can do. So we'll do it by taking perpendicular line, it will be easy. Question number 3.
So first of all, I will draw a line of measurement. What is given? 6.3. So A B equals to 6.3 centimeter. Now I will take two random points. So by taking drawing one line and then taking the measurement, I can do, but it will be easy for you to do by taking two lines. So I will take two perpendicular lines. So you know how to take draw perpendicular lines at any two points. I will do. So first of all, let me give here a point P. Let it as point P. So now I will draw perpendicular line. So you know how to draw by putting the needle of the compass. First of all, you have to draw an arc. So first of all, at point P, you put the needle of the compass and simply you draw an arc. Then by taking any measurement, but the measurement should be equal, you simply draw another arc like this. So here you will get another arc. Now with same measurement, you put the needle of the compass at this point and you draw another arc. First of all, you put the needle of the compass here. You draw one arc. When with the same measurement, you put the needle of the compass here, you draw another arc. Then with the same measurement, you draw by putting the needle of the compass at this point, you draw another arc like this. And by putting the needle of the compass at this point, you draw another arc like this. Then we can draw a straight line. Like this. It will be passing through this point. So in there also same, I'll take another line. Okay, so same like this, I'll draw another point. You can name it as Q, and the another time I'll draw the same R radius. Then by putting the needle of the compass at this point, I'll draw one arc like this again with the same radius. Don't change the length of this radius of the compass. With the same radius, I'll draw another arc here, and then after putting the needle of the compass at here, I'll draw one arc, and then by putting the needle of the compass at this point, I'll draw another arc. Then these two will be two parallel lines like this. There will be two parallel lines. Okay. So now the question is that the line should be 3 centimeter from it. So now, by taking the scale, you simply measure 3 centimeter. 3 centimeter like this. So you will get, for example, this just take this one as 3 centimeter. So I'll just simply cut there one time and there another time, then draw this point and this point. I can draw a straight line which will be just the 3 centimeter apart from this both the point. Okay. First of all, what I did, two perpendicular lines I draw, one at point P, another one at point Q. So two perpendicular lines. Then by taking the arc of this arc of 3 centimeter, for example, this is my scale. So 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, like this, 3 centimeter will be there. So you just take the measurement of this 3 centimeter. Then is by simply putting here, you cut here and there, you like this, you cut. Then you will get two intersection point, and from these two point you draw a straight line. Okay, you write this point is L and the next one is M. So this is your diagram. So now I'll write the steps of construction. Steps of construction. First one will be draw a line. Line AB of length. Length is given as 6.3 centimeter. Draw a line AB of length 6.3 centimeter. Point number two, it will be take two points P and Q on the line AB. Then what we did, after drawing the line,
AB, we took two random points, one P, another one Q.
So write, take any two points P and Q on the line AB. Take any two points on the line AB.
Okay. So now we'll draw point P and Q. We'll draw two perpendicular like this. We'll draw two perpendicular lines. So draw P and Q. Draw two line segment PL. What we'll do? We'll do two line. Draw two line segments PL and QM. So after drawing the this one, by taking the arc, you will cut it here and here. That will be the two points LM. So draw P and Q. Draw two line segments. PL and QM perpendicular to the line AB. Perpendicular to the line AB such that PL equals to QM equals to 3 centimeter. You write in the next line this one, such that PL equals to QM equals to 3 centimeter. So now last line of this construction, it will be point number 4, join LM end. So join LM, which is the required parallel line. So after joining LM, we'll get the required parallel line, which is the required parallel, which is the required parallel line.
Now question number 4, draw any triangle ABC and let D be the midpoint of AB. Using ruler and compass, draw the line through D parallel to BC to meet AC in E. As a measure D, so then you have to measure this one.
So this one I will show you what to measure, because the scale is not fully correct, the measurement will not be 100% correct. So you measure it nicely. I will simply show you how to write.
So question is that draw any triangle. So first of all, you draw a triangle of any measurement like this. Okay. Question is given, draw a triangle ABC. Draw a triangle of any measurement. And it is says that using ruler and compass, draw a line through D parallel to BC. Then it is said that let D be the midpoint. So how will you find the midpoint D? So D be the midpoint of AB. So question is, it is given like this, that somewhere there will be a point D on this line, which will be the midpoint. So we know how to do bisector. So first of all, you just take, for example, if this is somewhere there, it will be the middle point. So take little more than that, put the needle of the compass at A, you draw one arc like this, another arc will be somewhere there. Then again with same measurement, you put the needle of the compass here and you just cut this two arc like this. Then you just join with your compass, you will get the perpendicular bisector. We will get the perpendicular bisector. So somewhere there it will be point D. So now the question is given like this, that you are to draw a parallel. Draw a line parallel to it at a distance. So now you have to draw a parallel line through it. So how you can draw a parallel line? You simply measure. Okay, so now the question is to draw a parallel line. So again you have to draw somewhere there, you have to draw a, the line should be parallel to this one. So you simply by taking the radius also you can find, if you just take this is 0.1, then like this here will be somewhere there it will be. So if I simply join like this, I will get the parallel line. It will be, this is D, so somewhere there it will be. So one thing you do while drawing the triangle, you take all the side as 6 cm, then it will be the, you take it as equilateral triangle, it will be easy and it will be accurate also. So you take 6 or 8, if you are taking 8 cm this side, then you all the side you take as 8 cm, it will be easy. Or if you are taking it as 6 cm, then this side 6, this side 6, this side 6, you simply draw an equilateral triangle, it will be easy for you. Then you just join this one, there will be somewhere there it will be a point E, it is given E. So the question is that you are to find, do you find AE equals to EC? So then the question is to measure DE. So after drawing this one, you measure this line DE. So you write DE equals to, just after drawing this one, DE equals to, you find the measurement. If it is 5 cm or 6 cm, you write it like this. So I am you draw, you measure it nicely, you will get the measurement of this one. Then you have to find AE and EC. AE and EC, AE this measurement and this measurement also you have to find. So you find this one, then you measure this one with your scale, but just by putting the scale here you measure it like this, then you put the scale here, you measure it like this. So you will get 3 measurements. You find this thing, okay, you measure it, and then the question is given that do you find AE equals to AC? Yes, it will be correct that AE will be equals to AC. This measurement and this measurement will always be equal. So answer will be yes, AE equals to AC, and you write the measurement also. This measurement and this measurement will be same. If this one is 5 cm, then this one also will be 5 cm. If this one is 2, then this one also will be 2. So you write it here. If AE equals to 2 cm, then you write 2 cm here. If it is 4 cm, then you write 4 cm like this. So AE equals to AC equals to auto. And another thing it is given that, and half of BC is given, half of this one. You find the half of this one. If this line is 6 cm, then half of 6 cm you write like this, you cancel, you will get 3 cm, and then you measure this one DE, you will find that this one is also 3 cm. So you write like this, no need to write the steps of construction, simply up to this much you do. Okay, so you do it nicely. Hope you have understood how to do the parallel, how to draw parallel lines. If you have any problem, you can contact me. Thank you.